I thought it was a pretty well-played ball game, both teams, and nobody really gave each other anything. I mean, we made one error, didn't cost us anything, and it looked like it was going to be crazy there early, 3-3 after, four innings, and then it really settled in, and it just, became a game that was decided by the bullpens, and I thought obviously they got a big leadoff double there in the 10th. I think he had a couple of strikes on him, had a 3-0 count, went to maybe 3-1, 3-2, and fouled off the pitch and then hit a ball that just, was hit in perfect spot. And, we were in a little bit of a bind. They did a nice job with an 0-2 bunt, advancing the runner, and then first pitch sacrifice fly balls hit well. And, obviously they punched in another run that really cushioned it there. And, then Cotton held us down. It was a good ball game.
Question.
What would you say on the ejection? Just what was your whole thoughts on that play?
It's pretty simple. He went out of the baseline to avoid the tag. He can run out of the baseline. But when you go out of the baseline to avoid a tag, he's out. Simple. Bottom line.
Is that what you said to the ump? Or why do you?
No, well, I got thrown out for kicking the dirt. The line that he went outside of, that's pretty simple to see, too.
A lot of people say, they already scored a run. But what does that do when, they're able to add another one?
Well, it's like having a – if you're down two and all of a sudden you're down four, you double it. What makes it a lot – it's just difficult mentally. And who knows if we'd have scored a run, but it's a lot easier to score one than two. And, the call is what it is, and we still could have got them out without them scoring, and we didn't. So that's the way it goes.
What was the thought process there in the bottom of the 10th, taking out Mahan and Serrano for the freshman?
I wasn't in there, remember?
Yeah.
So I wouldn't know. I would have hit Hellbush, definitely, for Mahan, who's hitting a .150 against lefties. But the other move, probably just hoping somebody could hit a home run. But it probably, the key was probably to try to get Spoon to the plate.
I feel like after seeing this game, first game was a blowout, and the second game was a blowout, and today was pretty tight. Do you feel like that you're up there with LSU and can compete the rest of the
game? I always do. I think we can compete with LSU any day. And it's a good ball game. We just didn't win. I thought we pitched great. Our bullpen was outstanding. So was theirs. It was an extra inning game trying to win a series. And, hits were about the same. Both teams hit a couple balls that would have been out of the park if it hadn't been for the wind. And, it was a pretty even ball game.
With Serrano, did he kind of have a relapse of illness or something? Or when he didn't hit more?
I wasn't in the dugout. I can't be anywhere near there. I don't think so, though. They just pinch hit for him.
So you're not able to communicate at all?
I can't be anywhere. I can't be anywhere around there. I can't use a phone. I can't be in the tunnel. I can't be given instruction, run back and forth. You can't do anything. You're out of the game.
Any other questions?
What did you think of Ferris's performance in short?
He played second. I thought he did a great job. We're down 3-1. He hits a bomb, makes it 3-2. And obviously with two outs, it's a big base hit that tied it up. And even that ball he hit there in the last inning, as I was watching it on TV in the locker room, he hit it hard. He just hit it right at him. If he hit it somewhere else, he probably gets a base hit. So, proud of him. He's a good kid, a tough kid, and, I'm glad he had a good day.
Overall, are you happy with how your team played this weekend?
Yeah, I thought we played pretty well other than that ninth inning on Friday. That was a bad inning. But after that, we settled in and played pretty good. Like any team, we just felt like we left too many people out there as far as runners, and we had a chance early. You think about, I think it was the fourth inning, or maybe it was the third inning when we tied the game up, fourth inning, and we had a runner wet at first and third, nobody out. Vincent hits a bullet off the, it's just a laser off the pitcher. That ball doesn't hit him. It's in center field. We're first and third. The game's already tied, no outs. It's just the way the game works, that would have been probably a big inning, not a one run inning. That'd have been a two and a three run inning, I think. And, that's the way it works. And, hopefully we continue to get better, play well the next week. Got five games this week. We play two at Nebraska. They're leading the Big Ten conference, or at a minimum, I think they're tied for first with Indiana. And, then we got to come back and play A&M.
Was it just because of a left-hander, or are there other reasons that kind of shook the lineup up and moved?
Yeah, because they started a left-hander. Right-handers are hitting 170 off of him coming into today's game. left-handers are hitting 170 and right-handers were hitting about 270. So there's a big difference. And I think we had him on the ropes. We just didn't get enough runs off of him before they got him out of there.
From a defensive standpoint, do you consider maybe moving Dominic back to first full-time?
Well, I mean, I think Fisher's just as good a first baseman, just pretty close anyway. Covers that four hole a little bit better with that glove being on that hand. But, it depends. I mean, it's there, and it's always been there. It kind of really depends on how Ferris does. You know, can he hit right-handers good enough to stay in the lineup? And, you know, at least we know it's there and it's an option. And it really went pretty well today. We just didn't win the game.
What did you think about Ferris's game, first SEC start?
I thought he did. I mean, obviously he did a great job. I mean, I mentioned early, he hit a home run, a single, had two RBIs, made most of the plays look like to me. So he didn't look scared or intimidated playing in front of 9,000 people. And, like I said, he was a little bit raw when he got here. When I say raw, because he was a guy that didn't play summer baseball very much because he was a football guy. And then his senior year decided he wanted to be a baseball guy. So it worked out for us getting
him. I assume we don't get you tomorrow. Do you know anything about Nebraska? Or?
They can hit. I know they can really hit. Good mix of right and left-handed hitters in the lineup. Don't know much about their pitching. They played an extremely, extremely tough out-of-conference schedule. I mean, they went to Fullerton. I think they've been to New Mexico. They've been all over the place. And they got behind the eight ball as far as wins and losses, and then they've made it up in conference play. I think going into today, they were like 8-2 in the Big Ten. So it's made them better. They're going to be a good team.
You're going to pitch?
Yeah. I know Wright will probably throw some. I don't know if he's going to start the first game or the second game, and probably Killian will probably throw. I'd say Killian will probably start the first game, and Wright will probably go the second game.
You mentioned the bullpen. What did you think about Brandon Moore in particular today?
Well, he came in, and he at first it wasn't going real well, but then I thought once he got through those first couple of hitters out, got in the dugout, the first hitter, I think, in his second inning, a little bit all over the place, and all of a sudden it just started happening. And he gave us a couple of innings, two and a third or something, and three innings. So that was good to see, because he's been the one that we've been missing a little bit, that middle inning bridge guy that comes in if the starter doesn't go well. So it was nice for him to give us some innings and kind of get to the later inning bullpen guys. And then once they came in, I mean, Daniel came in against his lefties, did his job, and I thought Oliver was great. And, Beeks came in and pretty much did his job. They laid down a bunt on him, got a sack fly on him, but that's the way it works.
What about Fant? What did you think about him?
Just didn't command the ball. And even his changeup was up. The changeup that he gave up, the two-run home run to Bregman was, obviously it was a 2-0 pitch, which is more of a fastball count, but it was a changeup that was right down the middle. If he'd have missed a little bit out where it's supposed to be, it might have been a swing and miss or a ground ball, but he missed in the wrong spot and left the yard. So I guess just wasn't sharp. That wasn't sharp last week either. So hopefully he'll get it going this next weekend.
Thank you, Coach.
Okay.
We'll play in just a second.